Well, hello and welcome to another basic building block of code. And this is the follow-up from your functions introduction. And it's about using data with the functions. Now, what we're looking at is a global variable and constants are the kind of things that work for the whole program. And in this case, let's look at a constant, which is value added tax. Now, in computing, this is often shortened down to VAT. And currently in the UK, that's 20%. So if you buy a non-essential product, the government will add another 20% to the price, which they will then take in tax, value-added tax. Now, a good way of writing VAT is 0.2, so that's 20%. Yep. So I've said here my constant is equal to 0.2. Yeah. And if I wanted to work that out, it would be nice and simple. I'd go something like input, a price, so ask for a price to be typed in, and then simply that price will equal itself plus itself times VAT. Yeah, so if you typed in 100, that would be 100 times 0.2 is 20, plus 100 gives you 120, or £1.20, which would then be outputted. Right? Nice and simple. Okay, let's take a look at that, though, using a function. Now, here I've written a quick function. I've declared my constant, so I said that value added tax is equal to 0.2. That will go all the way through. I've then said on this that I've got a little function here. Here's my function. Function name is add VAT. There's no space there. And of course, my brackets straight away. This one I've indented and I've said end function, just to say that's where the function is. So this function has one line and it's the same line. Price is equal to price plus price times VAT. Okay. Now, down here, then I get my actual code. So my real code starts at this point. And at this point, I first ask somebody to input a price. I then call my function. So what we've got here is this is our call. Yep. And by doing that, we are saying, okay, now run this bit. So it's just going to run this code. It's going to change the value of price, this variable here. So, and now we're going to say new price is equal to price. Output, new price. I don't know about you, but this is kind of confusing because what we're doing, we're calling it and we're saying, okay, all the way up here now. Run this. Okay, now price. And you're saying, well, where did you get price from? Ah, well, you got price from here. So we're now doing price. Okay, and now what we're doing is we're changing the value of it. And by the time we've finished there, then we're kind of sticking that back down and hoping it comes down into here like this. And then we're doing a new price, and then we're outputting that new price to the screen. It gets a bit confusing. It will work, no doubt about it. It will work. So what we've got here is we've got a global variable, which is this price. And we're referring to price within our function and outside of our function. So that works fine, but it's confusing. It's much, much better to do it a different way. And the way we're going to do it is we're actually going to have a local variable just within the function itself. So price now is no longer a global variable. I'm still using a constant. That's fine, because the constant doesn't change. But my price now doesn't exist in my main code. So if we look at this, what I've got, let's use red again, okay, is this is where my main code starts. Yeah, and there's actually only two lines of it now. This is my function, right? And there's the global variable. So in programming code sequences, it will read this line first. That will go, okay, I've now got a constant, that's VAT. It will skip the function because it's not been called, and it will come down to this line. So in order of the way it will read it, it will read that first, then it will read that. At this point, now let's have a look. So total, that's a new variable, that's going to be a global variable, equals total plus, and now that's not a variable. That's actually the name of my function. So I can do that is I'm going total is equal total plus add VAT. Okay, so add VAT, well, what's my VAT going to be? Well, if you look at this point, I'm asking what's it cost? So say I can input here 100. So I'm going to write 100. So that input becomes 100. Now I call this. So this is now my call. When I do my call, I've typed in 100 here. It goes all the way up. And at this point, it declares a local variable, and that variable is price. So now price becomes whatever the number was, so that becomes 100. But that price only exists within here. And say, okay, that's fair enough. What how now happens? Now we return the value. So we're going to replace whatever was here, this bit here, with a value, this whole sequence, sorry. All of that will be replaced. So it returns it with price, which is 100, 100 plus 100 times VAT. That's going to be 120. So it now takes all of that, gets rid of it, and let's use yellow for this just to make it simple, and changes it and replaces it with 120. So I get total equals total plus 120, well, total before was zero, so it outputs 120. That is much, much simpler to do it that way. There's another advantage for doing this. If I undo all my scribbles, is doing it this way. What I can do is I can use this again. I can repeat it time and time and time again. And it doesn't matter what was called the last time, because that price will get rewritten every time. So a great advantage is that I could keep using this, is whether I put it in a loop or whatever else, so I can repeat. So what should we have? In fact, let's do it above properly. Let's do a nice repeat. Four times. And there we go. And now it will repeat the same code. That's a great advantage. Now, when you're throwing data in, there's one rule I want you to pay particular attention to. And that is using more than one variable. So you think, okay, what if I want to put more than one variable in? So again, here's my function. Yep. So it's going to skip that, come straight to line one of code. Line one says output summit. If we look, summit is the name of my function. So it's A comma B. Right. Well, if we look down here, I'm feeding in 2.4 comma 7. What will happen now, I'll use green, is that as we call this function, the A here will become 2.4, the B will become 7, and it will feed that data in. So that will become 2.4, and that will become a 7. And it will just return that number and replace this whole thing with 9.4. So it will output 9.4. Okay. Now, I chose 2.4 deliberately because that contains a full stop. And it's one of the reasons why we have the comma here. And we will always either have a comma or a semicolon, but it's usually a comma. In some cases, it could be a semicolon, but actually, there's still the commas in there. So why use a comma to separate our different values? Well, if we used a full stop, how would it know the difference between 2.4 and 2 and a 4? Yeah? Am I putting in one value called 2.4, or am I putting in two values, one that's a 2 and one's a 4? Well, it's very simple. The way it does it is we never use full stop. We always use comma. And then with a comma, we know it's going to be two separate values. Okay, there should be a quick quiz to do. Away you go.